We are back. Moments away from the start of the second overtime.
So the players are on the ice. Both teams are warming up, but Matteau was still in the locker room getting a skate fixed.
The only two guys left in the dressing room at the time was me and Eddie Olczyk.
Matty, in his broken English, he pretty much said, Eddie, come on, give me some luck. And I remember just grabbing a stick and putting my lips on his blade a little bit.
As a joke, I told him when I was ready, I said, I'll be back in 5 minutes with the winning goal. And he said, if you can do that, that would be great.
I can almost remember the entire 4.5 minutes that took place in the double overtime. First, Messier has this incredible opportunity where he's off to the side of the net and somebody along the board just throws something at Brodeur.
Hold the net, save, rebound, save Brodeur!
There it is, Marc Messier, he's gonna win it for us. Boom, nothing. And then the Devils take it down all the way down the other end of the ice.
Bernie Nichols will rebound out in the high slot, and he had the empty net, and I was on the bench, already standing up with my arms in the air. Ball game over.
Richter shoots, save, Richter, rebound!
Richter's looking for the puck, and it's hitting like 3 or 4 skates.
And as Sam just yells out, where's the puck?
Where's the puck? It's in the corner, and Nunez got it.
You know, just a few seconds later, Bukemoom drives it in, and I remember JD saying, wow, Matteau looks really fresh out there.
I remember thinking to myself, put your stick down and good things might happen.
Fetisov for the Devils plays it cross ice into the far corner. Matteau swoops in to intercept.
The puck had gone into the corner and I saw Stephane Matteau coming around the net.
I didn't think he was going to try and stuff it in. I thought he'd, you know, maybe take it by the boards or pass it out in front to someone.
Interesting enough, there was a discussion about Brodeur moving from right to left. And when he did, he would put his paddle down.
I put my stick down, and I just had a very weak shot on net.
It's funny, I'm about as distant as you can be on the ice, and I'm looking, and just... I swear I thought I saw the puck go in there.
I saw the puck going in very, very slowly. I didn't hear the crowd going crazy because they couldn't see it.
Matteau's hands go up, I saw the light go on.
And then the place went berserk.
Explodes off of Madison Square Garden.
I have people jumping all over me, and I'm trying to keep my arm up in the air like this because it's thriving.
Jumping up and down, screaming. Another call from the landlord
again.
He wants him out of the house.
He wants me out of the house.
The landlord calls.
And it was almost like you still have to let yourself. That's it. It's over. Like, they're not going to call back. It's over. We're going to the finals.
There's a woman behind me in the front row, so she's got these great seats, and she's freaking out, and she's cheering, and she looks down at me, and she said, this is my first hockey game, and I said, don't ever go to another one, because it'll never come close to this.
Aside from a child being born or getting married, I gotta throw that in for my wife, I'm sure she loves that, but there's never been any feeling I've ever had that comes close to that.
And 4 minutes and 24 seconds.
No idea who scored. My guess was taken in. And to this day, I'm Howie Rose. Amazing job by you.
He scores! Matteau! Matteau! Matteau!
When I left the building that night, and I'm listening to FAN, and they're playing the call seemingly every 5 minutes, and all the people calling in were as happy and excited about the call as they were about the game.
Fetisov for the Devils plays it cross ice. Matteau swoops in to intercept. Matteau behind the net, swings it in front. He scores!
Matteau, Stephane Matteau.
And the Rangers have one more hill to climb, baby. It's Mount Vancouver. The Rangers are headed to the finals.